What I'm not here to do is to defend the jahiliyyat of certain people. But what one has to look at objectively and in a very cold-hearted manner is this action against the sharia? If the answer is yes, it should be abandoned. If the answer is no, then it's jaiz.
The term Mawlid is a species of the Quran. Elijah means this is from Maryam. Wasalam alayhi yawma wulid wa yawma yamut wa yawma yub'athu hayya.
That the Mawlid is in perfect conformity with that with which the Prophet was upon and his ashab were upon. And I tell them humbly that they would not have La ilaha illallah if it was not for Muhammad Rasulullah. We talk about the fadila of Ramadan. We talk about the fadila of Dhul Hijjah. We talk about the fadila of the months of the Islamic calendar. We talk about the fadila of certain days in the Islamic calendar. But I tell you this, all of that fada'il, the greatness of every single aspect of our deen is contingent, it is dependent upon that day that the Prophet ﷺ came to this earth. There will be nothing in terms of the barakah, in terms of the thawab. In fact, chances are, if it was not for this day, I would be an atheist and most of the people I interact with would be Hindus. You see, this is the barakah of this day. This day transformed and purified the entire universe. So I ask these people, set aside that nonsense you read in that book which has a nice fancy cover. And we will make the argument tonight, because there are certain people who assert that Ibn Kathir writes that it was a Shia king who started the process of Mawlid Un Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and prior to that there was no basis in the deen. But this is wrong, and tonight inshallah you quoted the beautiful ayat of the Quran pertaining to the completion of the deen. These people, as I said at the beginning, they allege, well, this deen, therefore are you asserting it's incomplete? Absolute nonsense. In fact, I put it out to these plonkers. Are they asserting the deen is incomplete? Where he is saying that there is not a single scrap of dalail, sahih, hasan, da'if, maudu, where the Prophet ever forbade the remembrance of birthdays. Not a single scrap of evidence are these people telling me that it is haram. Therefore, the Prophet forgot to make something haram before he left this world. Half of our deviancy in this day and age is that we have an extreme-minded youth who are bored with their day-to-day living, and so they find their entertainment in debating the deen. And I humbly request, stop debating the deen. Stop having internet debates. Move away from it. The 40, 50 minutes you've cut and pasted an argument and insulted someone else on the other side of the world or land, you could have been doing the dhikr of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is not upon the job, it is not the duty, it is not the responsibility of the awam to defend Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah. We have the ulama like Qibla Mufti Saab who do it eloquently, articulately, and in a way that closes the argument once and for all.
Anything if you disagree with the Mawlid, step forward now, don't be scared. Step forward now or forever.